to Monday Music at the Museum. This is, I think, our fourth week now. Someone just asked me how long we might be doing these, and well, we're going to continue at least for the next several weeks, and if you have any requests or anything in particular that you'd like us to try to put together, we sure would, and just send us notes in the comments or send us an email or let us know somehow. So tonight, it is Memorial Day. It's the day when we remember those who have fallen on the battlefield in defense of our country. And we were privileged to have a beautiful service, short little service at the cemetery today. And the volunteers put up all the beautiful big casket flags as well as all the small grave flags and with the flowers. It was a beautiful sight to behold. And we thank all the people that make all that happen. And we thank all of you for watching and for tuning in. We do post these live Facebooks to YouTube. It takes us about a day or two to get that all downloaded. And then they're all available. You can subscribe to the Quincy Valley Historical Society YouTube channel. And then you can watch the past ones as well as all of the ones coming up. So tonight, because it's Memorial Day, we have a patriotic theme, and we have several people that are new that are helping us tonight, and we really appreciate them. I'll be introducing them as the evening goes on. So first of all, I want to introduce to you back again is Glenda Bishop. She's the CEO of our hospital, and she's also a fabulous pianist, and I've known her for a long, long, long time. And she's going to be playing several pieces tonight. The first one is America the Beautiful. Sweet out of the mouth of babes. We can all learn. Thank you, Maverick. Really, really good. And to follow that up, we're going to sing a song that talks about our pledging our allegiance to our land, just what he did for us. Okay. This is God Bless America. When the storm clouds talk about the next piece that she's going to perform, how important it is, the meaning it has for her.
Family and heritage are so important to me, and when Memorial Day comes around, there are family members who we have lost and grave sites that I can't go back to, but it is precious to me to be able to bring those pictures forward and to be able to look at the grave of my grandfather, who served in several wars. And just down the road from our house, I mean, his name was Thomas Sullivan. Just down the road from our house, though, about 2 miles, is a sweet, serene, lovely cemetery. And in that cemetery is buried my husband's uncle. His name is Thomas Durden, and he also served in several wars. I also have lost 2 uncles in the last few years who served in the military, and those are graves that I've never been privileged to go to. But I am so thankful for all of those who've served and given their lives. Some of them did not lose their lives in service, but they fought for our country. And so today it's so precious to me to be able to remember those in my family who wore a uniform and those in our community who have family members who also so proudly wore the uniform of our military. So the song that I want to play for you really pays tribute to all of the branches of the military tonight, and I'm sure that you'll recognize them as I go through them one by one, hopefully.
Other battlefields and other soldiers also. picture. This is a picture of Corporal John Fleckenstein, and he was one of the first people to be buried in Burke, which was what we call George, out by the town of George now. And this young man was in a family that homesteaded out there in that area. And when the call came for World War I, he was enlisted in World War I in the Army and was sent to Camp Lewis, which we now know as Joint Base Lewis-McChord, was sent to Camp Lewis and then was sent over to Europe. And it's so poignant. This is a young man here. He was born 1895 in Minnesota, and he grew up in Burke. He was the son of John and Teresa Fleckenstein. He was killed in action October 9th, 1918, Company G, 361st Infantry, at the age of 23 years old. And in a poem given to the family, we have a first-person account, actually, of this family and what they went through in their homestead out at George, in the George area. And one of the things in that story is a partial part of a poem that was given to the family after they had been given the notice that he was killed in action. It says, "Yes, the dreadful message came. Father took it at the door. Corporal John O. Fleckenstein killed in action. That was all it said. No more. In the house, dry eyes and peaceful grief and pride, the story told. People passing by paid tribute when our blue star turned to gold." And if you don't know what that means, there's a thing called gold star mothers and gold star families. And you're given a flag when you have someone go overseas in action, and it's a blue star on a white background. And then if they die in action, you're given a gold star instead of the blue star. So this is the story of Corporal John Fleckenstein. He was killed in what we would know as Flanders Field in the Battle of, and I can't say it in French, but Yves-Yopres, over in what we would know as France, Belgium, in that area. So our very first soldier killed in battle from Quincy. We also had two from World War II and three from the Vietnam era, and none since then that we know of, so thank goodness. But there are all these other battlefields, and in a moment we're going to have Jackie Ovenell come up, and she's going to present the Gettysburg Address to us, which was from a battlefield in our nation's past, what we would call the Civil War, the war between the states. And I think she's going to tell a little bit about this and what it means to her. She has learned this by heart. And are you going to share when you told it on our trip, Jackie?
Oh, I hadn't thought about it, but I can.
Okay, yeah, I'm going to let her share about this. And after she's finished, then we have the privilege tonight of having Dale Hille come up and sing another song that was really important during the time of the Civil War, the Battle Hymn of the Republic. And it's still very appropriate today. So Jackie, if you'd come up, we're gonna get her mic so we can hear her well. I'm gonna move this over. Okay, turn this on.
Words are important to me. And so through the past few years, I have daily said these precious words, 272 of them, first said by Abraham Lincoln on the battlefield at Gettysburg in Pennsylvania. And I was privileged to accompany a group on a Civil War tour that Harriet provided for this area, and privileged to stand at the same place as Abraham Lincoln at the Gettysburg Battlefield Cemetery and say these words. One word alone is not sufficient, but when these 272 words were put together, it has resonated for us throughout these many years, and it's good for us to hear these words again. Fourscore and 7 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation, conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal. Now we are engaged in a great civil war, testing whether that nation or any nation so conceived and so dedicated can long endure. We are now met on a great battlefield of that war. We have come to dedicate a portion of it as a final resting place for those who died here, that that nation might live. It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this, but in a larger sense, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hallow this ground. The brave men, living and dead, who struggled here have hallowed it far above our poor power to add or detract. The world will little note nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. It is rather for us, the living, to be here dedicated to the great cause remaining before us, that from these honored dead, we take increased devotion to the cause for which they gave their last full measure of devotion, that we do here highly resolve that that nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom, and that that government of the people, by the people, and for the people, shall not perish from this earth. Amen.
The Battle Hymn of the Republic. Originally a camp medium hymn, with the music attributed to William Steff, was titled, "O Brothers, Will You Meet Me on Canaan's Happy Shore?" It evolved then into John Brown's Body. Then in 1861, at the beginning of the throes of the Civil War, Julia Ward Howe, the wife of a government official, wrote a poem for the Atlantic Monthly, in which she was paid $5. The magazine called it the Battle Hymn of the Republic. This song, which was definitely a Union anti-slavery song, was soon adopted by both the North and the South. Both Union and Confederacy soldiers together sang this song, which goes to prove that whatever the discrepancy or the difficulty we go through in this world, God's truth marches on.
My eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He is trampling out the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He has loosed the fateful lightning of his terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on. Hallelujah. counsel men before his judgment seat. Oh, be swift, my soul, to answer him. Be jubilant, my feet. Our God is enlarging on.
Memorial Day.